Okay, we are live. I'm currently logging on because I'm definitely a professional streamer. Twitch affiliate, by the way. If I could get a side tube.
Crazy outfit put together before this.
I meant to switch the data center. No. Why is there like no etherite that I can use in this area?
as is now forever stuck in my head. Oh, shoot. You ever come across a meme that you hear your friend's voice in it, and that's all that's heard?
Indeed.
Yeah, that just happened.
I just need to get to Ward 6. There you go.
We can't fly in here, can we?
I don't think so.
Nope, it's a residential.
Any oversight.
Okay.
Yeah, can the Omega in the front row please get down?
Actually down in front.
If you were the owner of a male Omega, you left your lights on.
Man, if I had 5 kill for every time I heard that one.
You, with a Fenrir.
Actually, I left my Fenrir over on the dock.
Why is it docked? I didn't know it was a submersible. Technology is booming. Next flying whales.
Shuriganic Shorn, or just look for the giant crowd of people.
Yes.
All right.
The giant crowd of people. Chocobo.
Chocobo. You see, we already have a pretty good crowd of people gathering for the day 2 of Midvina Madness Games. Now for probably proper introductions. Hello everybody watching. This is in fact Midvina Madness Day 2. I am your humble streamer, host, person, commentator, Gale Lightrun. Joined by my co-host here, Just the Tilt. Dylan Thorne, and Thiji Higuri.
A pleasure, everyone.
You know, the only person we're missing is Groot.
Groot will be here eventually.
Assuming that he's not passed out in a book right now?
Probably.
Hey, does anybody have the Chocobo Eats app? I need to order food.
No, I forgot to install it on my tombstone. I'm sorry.
Damn it.
That sounds like an FMV waiting to happen.
The entire time while waiting for your food, the theme just plays on loop.
I wonder if Mog Dash is open. Wonder if Mog Dash is open. So, Dylan, curious question.
What's that?
Have the markers been put on the map yet?
I am not sure. Let me check the party finder. Yes, they are there, actually. Let me...
Alright, we're gonna need those.
Doing some walk around cam. This always looks so cool seeing just like a bunch of people at the beach. Is that an
animal? Yes, it is!
Wait, what?
And I am friends with them.
No, we just got visited by royalty here. Former royalty. Depending on what everyone is in Final Fantasy XIV.
Incredible.
Technically, she's not there, but...
I mean, yes, who is this pink... Who are these strangers?
Well, it's just the one in the pink that's just, that you should be wondering about.
Seems vaguely familiar. Just can't place it.
Are you still on party teleport? Did you get the markers ready?
I got kicked out.
Unfortunate.
Just kind of one of those. Hey, you? Yeah, you! Kicks in water.
Look at these golden players right here.
Those would be the Old Dog Guild Turtles.
Yes!
Old Dog Guild Turtles, part of today's Game 1. Oh, wait, why did I add that? What?
Uh-oh.
Versus the Kugane Koban Crushers, where I'm trying to find. They're right over here, right up front. Ready to throw down.
And then following them will be the Evilly's High Seraphs and the Garlemald Salt Barons.
If I can find them, I will take screenshots.
Why does the salt suck?
Why are they so salty?
I mean,
I don't look. Yeah.
We should probably look at their track record. Maybe that'll answer something.
Maybe.
The salt barons are salty because they come from the salt flats in what was formerly Imperial Alamigo, which is now just Alamigo.
There's a little Namazu taking a swim.
So are they technically trespassing?
I think, maybe?
I don't think that they're actually technically in Alamigo anymore. It's just one of those things that they actually, over the past couple of years, they were such fan favorites as far as the team. They had like a really great storyline, so everybody wanted to keep them around. And they chose to keep the name Salt Barons, despite, you know, not being in that area anymore. So
I get it now. They're just like salty.
Yeah, like actual like American football, how the Indianapolis Colts used to be the Baltimore Colts. So they kept the mascot even though they moved.
I'm from Baltimore.
I get it now. They're just salty because they lost their land.
Ha!
Among other things.
There you go.
Well played.
I'm gonna go back to my room now. Alright, so for you non-role players out there, this is Blitzball. We have got a game coming up here in just a few moments.
That's
please
right.
Bear with me, I got a truck outside that thinks that they can be loud.
It's the worst timing.
Mm-hmm.
That is in fact correct. This is the one and only game mode Blitzball, originally from Final Fantasy X, for all you non-Square Enix fans. Or just those not familiar with Blitzball in general.
Just know that every Blitzer knows that when you have the ball,
you gotta score. And these teams better hope that they score well, because, man, last week's games were pretty tense. I'm talking.
A shame I could not attend. Being on the other side of the world, I will have to miss a few of them.
Just gonna say that Eclipse has scored 4 goals, so you know.
And you know what?
We had the ball, we scored.
He scored pretty hard. Meanwhile, Limsa Lamenta with a
scorching 4-point win over the, man, why am I bad?
I believe it was the Thavnir Immortal Lions.
Yes, the Thavnir Immortal Lions. My memory is totally on point today.
Our newest team to grace this season.
And exactly. Newcomers from all the way over to Damascus. Showing off with a great show of force. Unfortunately, they couldn't make it to the next winner's round. They'll be going to the loser's bracket in the coming weeks. Versus the loser of the first game versus the Alamigo Royal Griffins, the Ishgardian Heavensguard, which put up an amazing defense, I gotta say. With only 1 point on the board the entire time of that match. And it looks like we're actually about to start.
My favorite part.
I'll be right back, they're shouting.
Time to blitz now, y'all.
We move.
I can already see both teams getting fired up for the first game. Hopefully the chat can hear Space Jam.
I'm confident they do.
Okay, sure. Oh my god. Jam. Here we go. I can never stop. Hello, everyone. Bang, bang. You're so welcome. I seem to have missed a banner. I'm actually bad.
Uh-oh.
There we go. It seems that I missed a banner for the sponsors. Oops. Easily fixed. Is the ship coming straight for the beach?
Apparently so, and it's already firing its cannons.
Oh, well, that's not good. It'll probably get away from the main shoreline.
Indeed.
Guild Turtle got overtaken. Wait.
Don Coconino always was one for embellishment.
Wait, they broke the... Huh. Oh. Limsa sending a message. I thought they were done with piracy. Okay, everyone on the beach have got a roll / randoms. Oh, I didn't get a bottle of booze. I'm seeing, someone rolled a 58. That's not good. Ooh, Vivian Jadestone with a free bottle of booze. Ooh, there goes Mika with another one. Oh, Julian. That's a lot of folks getting hit.
Good thing I have a parasol.
Good thing it's also a good thing it's gold, so it's not. It's a soft metal.
At least I assuming hope the glass doesn't break on people's faces.
Yeah. I mean, it also needs to probably take another 29 hits for it to break. That's a good joke for all you Minecraft players. Where are we supposed to sleep? Here they come. Ooh, made it just in time for that amazing switch. Incredible. That's a good angle right there. Oh, the Guild Turtle's going all out with this uniform. What?
They call it their best suits.
I gotta say, the gold here works better than what they usually wear.
Yes. Maybe they're just trying this out. This is definitely a new development that I've seen.
Yeah. Well, let's hope the armor doesn't weigh them down.
Yes, many people seem to forget that before they take to the water.
Yeah, wearing armor in a sporting event like this usually not optimal unless you're probably built like a Flames and Hammersmith. Look at that mountain of a man. It's actually insane. Let's see if I can find the sponsors for our merry band of rich people.
I know Don Coconier is over towards the docks.
Let's see. Ah, yes. Well, currently sponsored by the Guild Tribe. There should be a document here somewhere. Sponsors on the main dock. Is that? All right. Here they come, it's the Kugane Koban Crushers! Look at some lost shows in the chat.
This is a home game for them, so let's see them represent.
Closer for an aerial view. I get a nice angle on the action. Look at that positioning. That's some nice clean positioning right there. There we go. As always, this is a 6-on-6 match. Goalie, 2 defense, 2 offense, and the centers. Always a coveted spot for the offense. Intimidation tactics are coming out strong, yelling at each other. Trying to find the main document from...
Let it begin. The blitz off.
And we are off with the... Ooh. Alright, rolls. Senators have rolled. It looks like it's going to be Nicole Levinstorm taking the lead with a 794. Off to a great start for the Crushers. Sixty minutes on the clock, and the Crushers are now first to move.
Why is there a rocket on the Blitz Bowl?
Who brought weapons onto the field? Hello? Come on, we're out here trying to have a good little game of Blitz Ball, and people are shooting rockets everywhere.
The Don should keep a better eye on those type of things.
Why can't I find the main document for Blitz Ball? Am I actually okay? Blitz Ball macros, nope.
The Blitzball Kid is going for a tackle towards Zuliod.
Alright, it looks like Dole is moving, trying to move past the offense and directly into the field. It looks like they're going to be slipping one person into the defensive line while the other two are hanging back. Similar tactic to the Royal Griffins last week.
Oh, of course. It was the Donnie sabotaged the ball. Why am I not surprised?
Of course. How appropriate that the Don would try to do something to help the Guild Turtles win this match.
As always, there's lots of commotion happening in the center.
Oh, it's gonna be an absolute massacre again. I'm looking forward to it. You know, it's kind of funny that the richest, the sponsor for the richest team is the one doing the dirtiest tactics. Meanwhile, teams like the Royal Griffins or the Sirens, Storm Sirens, they're just out here they take things into their own hands. Quite literally.
Like, this is definitely quite the gray area on the spectrum.
It's baffling.
To say the least.
Yeah. Alright, ball carry with it. Ooh, Nicole tries to pass the ball over to the Doe, but it looks like he's gonna be intercepted by Naroki. Unfortunately, that's gonna be Oldaz ball now.
Let us see how long the Guild Turtles can hold it.
Hopefully, they better hope it's good. They can hold on to it as well as they can hold on to their money. Zulion retaliating with a nice 696. Blitzball kid with the defense. Let's see here. East looking up tackle Doe and making sure she doesn't get anything. Oh, but unfortunately.
Doe counters with a staggering 947.
947 for Doe. Blitzball kid unfortunately gets blocked with a 456. Now, also moving towards Doe. Ooh, with just barely. Doe manages to slip on by.
Press the attack, little Aura.
Doe's a force to be reckoned with. If you ever see her at Fight Nights, ooh boy. First-hand experience, she hits. Let's see. Elegant, looking to wait for the right time. Nicole going in for a block on Yisu. Ah, but unfortunately nothing. Lancelot next. Attempting to block the ball holder, Naroki. Looks like Naroki gets blocked by one. Blitzball Kid having a bad day.
He truly does want to become a Blitzball when he grows up.
It's an honorable dream. You have to respect it. And looks like Doe's diving straight into goalie line. It's gonna be Naroki with the play here. Let's see what they do in their turn.
Ah, she must mean to distract the goalie.
But with a whole lecture on Mahjong? Insane. And yet, it works. Naroki with the pass to Lancelot, and it seems to have worked. Not to Lancelot, pass to Yisu. Lancelot tries to block it, but unfortunately the ball just curves right out of his grip. My door closed? Yes it is.
The ball is now owned by Yisu.
And Yisu's already in the defensive line with only one blocker on in position. Let's see here where the Guild Turtles moves.
Yisu's returning. Yep.
Yep. Looks like Yisu's gonna try to block off Doe. It's gonna take him another turn to be able to do so, though. Zulian moving into Nicole. Looking to kick him in the gut. Classic move.
Can never go wrong with an honest drop kick.
Nope, cannot. If it ain't broke,
don't fix it.
Ooh. Don putting out 50 million on the Guild Turtles today. Bold, bold, bold move, but also they got money. They can risk it. Whatever, rich people.
So they say.
Lancelot blocking Naroki. Ooh, that's a 959 to 35. That you hate to see it.
Double-digit roads are very disheartening.
Oh, it's the worst. Even worse, if you roll like a 1. Or, in some cases, a whole 0. Oof. I've seen it happen, and my goodness, it's embarrassing.
My heart sinks.
If you want to know more about it, just tweet at JudePaw. Let's see, Elegant blocking Yisu.
Oh, a single digit!
Oh, speaking of single digits, Zulian with the... Oh, no.
That's even more disheartening than a double digit.
Oh, no. At least with like 100, there's a little bit of pain. But you get into the singles, bruh. You hate to see it. Alright, ball carrier. Let's see what they do.
I believe Yisu and Alun is still in possession.
Let's see here. Yisu wasn't blocked, so it looks like they're moving straight into one.
This could be your chance.
This could be it. With only Kara at the goalie, at the goal line, and no other blockers.
It's all on her.
Yep.
Elegant won't be able to reach her in time to assist.
It's just flat rolls versus flat rolls. Z- Zulian going for an elbow this time with a 419, and Nicole retaliating with a 970. Let me see what the sponsors for today's current match is. If I can find... Ten seconds left on the clock for the Guild Turtles to take action. Now, strike into defensive pose. You gotta respect it. Naroki going for a block on Blitzball Kid. Oh, and a 196 on Blitz Kid.
He's doing his best, just doesn't seem to be good enough at the moment.
The kid's trying, you gotta respect it.
Yeah, he has lots of heart.
Alright, time for the Crushers to do their thing. Ooh, Lancelot with a powerful block against Naroki. And that's a 282 against a 912.
Looks like he's going in for a punch at Zulian's nose, and it looks like he succeeded. A 507 versus a 470.
Apparently, gotta fix my sponsor banners real quick. Because one very important banner is not showing. Technical difficulties, everyone. Ooh, East with an 826 against Doe. Alright, Guild Turtles. After this turn, it's gonna be. It all just boils down.
The commotion's nice, but yes, the ball carrier is currently in the enemy team's goal. One honest shot's all it takes. Yisu shoots!
Isu with a 501, Carl with a 642. That's gonna be an intercept by the goalie. And now it's her turn. Now it's her choice to throw it to one of the people in the center, or actually throw it all the way to Nicole. Because he can't.
Nice.
Hey, it's enough.
I'll say a nice wash away for the Koban Crushers.
Exactly, but you know you can't pass from goal to goal, so best bet's probably gonna be Nicole. I believe she's free from blockers.
Yes, the only person standing in her way being Nal.
I don't believe Nal was able to get any rolls off.
That's gonna be a negative for us, Gale.
Alright. Let's see what the play is.
Ball's in Kugani's court. We move.
Lancelot versus Naroki. That's going to be a 412 versus 516. Good defense by Naroki. It's a pretty good back and forth so far. Let's see if we have sponsors. Oh, it's all just the banners. Let's see, Elegant moving directly into one to help fend off Yisu in case they manage to pass it off to her again.
A good tactic indeed. They will be left open temporarily.
Let's see, Blitzball Kid actually moving forward into the offense. Now tries to flex on Nicole, but unfortunately Nicole Levinstorm just not having.
Didn't flex hard enough, it seems.
Unfortunate.
Now it's that spunky kid with all the heart in the world.
Oh, speaking of heart, That's really all he's got. His strength is just, unfortunately, abysmal. That's a 976 against an 83 from Zulian and Blitzball Kid. Meanwhile, East and Doe. 908 versus 610, that's a pretty good scrap. 10 seconds left for the Guild Turtles to take action. Alright, reposition is Nicole's court. Open, free from blockers. What's it gonna do? What are they gonna do?
Finally got some pressure off of Connor Skyfallen. Another two enemies in A.
Yep, it looks like Noroki and Yisu are free right now. Even if they were to pass out the ball, it's gonna be a plus 200 if they were to try to shoot from A.
It's good spell trouble for Zulian. He's the only defender at C, or forward at C in the center.
The knee is also coated in an anti-poor Teflon. Hey, remind me to dropkick East when this game is over. Let's see how that anti-poor Teflon works against the Light Run special.
Indeed. Now sitting or swimming pretty at Zone B.
1 and only, Nile Dustbringer.
Meanwhile, there's a party going on at the Guild Turtles goalpost, it seems.
Oh, yeah. That is correct, CG.
Everyone's all over the place.
It really is. I wasn't able to see the Storm Sirens game, but I'm assuming it was probably something similar to this, right? I don't know. I wasn't able to see it.
Your guess is as good as mine.
The world may never know. Ooh, Doe goes in to block East, and you know what? She takes care of business for us. She breaks off that anti-poor Teflon.
A victory. A victory for the small folk.
A victory for the non-rich.
I'm all for it.
Ooh, East going for a headbutt on Doe. Rolls a 235. That's probably not gonna work. Zulian working a lock down Blitzball Kid. Doe easily blocks off the headbutt.
Don says he's just floating there. Oh no, Blitzball Kid!
Blitzball Kid, rolling the 80s, bro.
Don't be discouraged, kid. You can do this.
He'll be a Blitzball someday. You're certainly getting kicked around like one.
Didn't say the path was going to be easy.
Alright. It's all down to Nicole again. Will she do it? Oh, it was a straight shot into the goal.
Here goes Nicole. And 618.
618 versus the goalie. And it's a 193 from Lane Krieger. Ladies and gentlemen, we got the first goal. If I'm not mistaken,
yes it is.
We got the first goal of the game, everybody. Old Kugane Koban crushers with that nice, nice roll.
Let's get some Washoes in the chat.
Washoes in the chat. Let's go. And don't forget, on Curious Instigator stream, !! Koban Crushers. All lowercase. Gets you that sweet, sweet merch page. appropriately, let's go to a quick little sponsor segment. Let's see if I can find one of those. I'm assuming the Crushers are sponsored by someone, right?
Yes, I believe it was it Third Eye Sushi?
Ooh, they're actually sponsored by three people. They got Forest Shocks' Shortstop of Crisplody Booms, Nature's Oath, and Third Eye Sushi. I actually went to Third Eye Sushi once for karaoke night. It was phenomenal. Got it.
Really? I had no idea they had karaoke there.
They did. I believe, yeah, I went there once on a different character. Ooh, Nicole just barely gets the ball of Resilient. Third Eye Sushi, pretty great atmosphere.
I enjoy clean. East appears to be commanding his fellow turtles to deactivate a Sigma mode.
A Sig what now?
That just reeks of Olagon. Olagon.
Olagon.
Tampering.
Oh, Nala has something and now her suit's glowing. A tremendous amount. That's very concerning. Hey, Don? Is this. No, he's gonna say it's legal.
Yeah, has this been field tested? It better have been.
Forget field tested. Is this HBA. Like.
Admitted?
Approved? Hello?
I'm sorry. The only question that's going through my mind is it creating heat? And if we. So, can we use it in a jacuzzi?
Okay.
Theoretically speaking, of course, so that long as you don't short circuit.
That is a valid question. That's also a valid statement. Is this running with electricity? Because if that's the case, the Guild Turtles might be in a bit of personal trouble.
Money is no excuse for recklessness. But I digress. Back to the battle. Kata's apparently putting some sort of adhesive on the Crusher's gloves.
When did they have the time to do that?
Look, not even that. Wouldn't its efficacy be nullified being in water?
There's a lot of good questions happening today.
People should have paid attention in science.
Alright, Doe moving up to B. Blitz, let's see here. Lancelot moving from defense into A, actually. Oh, Blitzball Kid also joining the offense at B. Let's go. Let's go, kid.
Go for it, my man.
Nicole's trying to pass off the ball to Doe. Oh, but Yisu with the block. Minitot, your announcers for tonight are myself, Curious Instigator, also known as Gale Lightrun, and Thiji Higuri.
A pleasure as always.
Yes. You can find his point of view, his, then, what are your pronouns? The male pronouns, or?
Pronouns?
Yeah.
He, him, etc.
Okay, you can find his, you can find. I gotta be sure about this. I don't want to get canceled. I just got affiliate.
Ah, I see. Welcome to the fold.
Yes, thank you very much. You can find Thiji's point of view stream over at twitch.tv/ThijiHigudi.
All one word, of course.
All one
because
word.
Because they don't allow spaces. Oh wait, they're restarting the round apparently.
Oh, I think they accidentally hit him. I think there was a bit of a misclick, so everything is.
Oh, they're restarting this particular. Okay.
Oh, Snow's catering tonight. Thank you very much for bringing that sweet, sweet food. Every sporting event always has to have some sort of good food. Just...
Oh, for sure!
That's a given. It's like hot dogs at a baseball game.
Yes. Can't display height properly without some food in your belly.
Absolutely. Oh, whoops. Night message. Oh, that's...
He's retreats to the goalie position in style.
Hey, Kroa, come sit over here.
Oh, where are you at? I'm currently the docks.
Oh,
yep. I'm just off the docks too.
Yeah. Cool. I'm at the sake table.
Hey, get your drink on.
Yeah. Oh, East with a 99. You hate to see that. Alright, Minitot is providing the catering today with a turtle menu. Tiny URL dot turtle menu, if I'm understanding that correctly.
Eat like a turtle, a guild turtle.
Later, Rich, says Doshin.
A nice retort to East's later pours.
Oh, that's correct. We also have the SLM streaming with their own streams. Twitch.tv/the_SLM. That's 2 S's, ALIM.
Appreciate it.
No problem. Got it. I'm not gonna try. Alright, ball carrier's turn. Isu tries to pass over to the Naroki. Oh, but Nicole shuts that down with a 915 versus 106.
Nothing flashy, nothing fancy, just a straight steal. Well done, Nicole. Balls in Kugane's court.
Balls in Kugane's court. And it looks like Nicole... Let's see, where's Nicole on the field? Nicole's still primed in center. It's going to be a 3v2, though, with Lancelot helping her out. Against Yi Sunal and Doro, Sulian Xanth, and Naroki Aetherius.
Once again, Doa somehow managed to slip past the Guild Turtle's defenses and is now partying with Lane. Huh. She's definitely good at this, it seems.
Doa's definitely a fighter. Quick moves, quick. You just can't keep up. Elegant, holding fast. How about some soy sauce with these dumplings? Okay. Oh, Blitzball came with a 953!
Alright, Blitzball kid!
Alright!
He's getting his break!
Certainly breaking something.
Whose sassy child is this? Says East. Tavio receives the realest edible of his life.
It looks like Don's got some facts for us. Tavio's the face behind Tavio's New World Tacos. Tavio's New World Tacos are seasoned with authentic New World spices due to a trade agreement with the Gilmeister family, continuing now with Reginald's daughter Stephanie after her father's tragic and untimely passing.
Ooh. Oh, lovely.
Another death
that has been unexplained.
There seems to be a lot of those.
Yes.
It's kind of concerning. We live in a very dangerous world.
Only amongst the aristocrats.
I think everyone's got a pretty fair amount of pretty fair chance of dying. Some probably more than others. Is that a proper defense by Nicole? Let's see here. 289 versus Isu. Naroki, 389. East, 7765. My goodness, Nicole just...
Nicole Levinstorm is on fire!
Nicole Levinstorm... Actually... Goodness gracious. Three blockers. Nothing worked.
And she trounced all three of them.
That's gonna be a clean pass over to either Blitzball Kid or actually Dodoshin over at the goal line. I think. That's it. That's the direct pass to Dodoshin at the goalie line. However, she's gonna have to contend with Nal and Lane for defense.
Let's see how she does now.
To figure out how I can get closer to see the dice.
I can see all of the rolls is pretty fine over at my spot. Oh, but you're probably trying to get a different angle.
Nice last defending by blocking Naroki with a 906. Naroki with a 650. Block successful. Elegant, not wanting to leave Kara wide open, decided to hold at Zone A.
Let's see, Nicole Levinstorm trying to block off Isu. Oh, but it's an 824 versus a 428.
It's literally the numbers backwards.
That's pretty great. That's... Alright.
Ooh, get dunked on, Nicole. Tough break.
Absolutely dunked on. She really did say, come on and slam, and get dunked. Alright, Guild Turtle. Zulian alright out of the gate with a block. No, not a block. He's moving forward into A.
Oh, no.
Let's see, but now trying to block off Doe, only rolling a 75.
The Rock... Looks like that Sigma mode enhancement isn't really working out the snuff. Doe easily dodges it.
Really should have gone for the Omega.
Indeed.
Oh my goodness. Croatoan just sent a screenshot of where they are.
Yeah, I am currently under the sake table.
Oh, East blocking off Blitzball Kid again with a 416 versus 95. Naroki versus Nicole. That's a 78 versus 75. That's a awkward block. It's like you're just noodle arms on both sides.
Yeah. During the offseason, ECU also plays for Dawn's Water Wasps and has been pictured in many of his old sports magazine swimsuit editions.
She declines
the comment. I mean, everyone likes Vieira. I don't see why there's such an issue.
Everyone likes Vieira, but apparently, I guess she's not. She's just not in the. She just doesn't want to confirm or deny.
Nothing wrong with having a bit of pride.
Hey, don't forget to look forward to the Royal Griffin Swimsuit Edition. We got some lookers.
Beg pardon?
You heard me, Royal Griffins, Swimsuit Edition. Anyways, Doe goes for the shot. Oh, but almost gets it, but Lane just smacks it.
Oof.
Just smacks it right out.
Had she made this, it would have been one goal short of a hat trick.
It would have been great. Oop. There's going to be a pause on the field. Someone's getting swapped out.
Sammy Malkut replaces Yisu.
Wonderful plays by Yisunal and Doro. And it looks like Tavio is also switching out Zulian. Interesting. Replacing both forwards. Tavio Miguel, the Taco King.
I can honestly go for some shop tacos right now. Perhaps after the game.
Oh, Tavio denying tacos. For the enemy team. That's unfair treatment. What if I wanted to get some tacos, huh?
Yeah.
Just because I'm not a guild turtle doesn't mean I don't get tacos? Is that it?
This should never be exclusivity for tacos.
I actually never had like a hard shell taco before.
Speaking of tacos, Tavio was looking to block Elegant with one of his own!
What? Taco block. A blocko.
How did he even
Yeah, actually, where was he carrying these?
That thing's gonna get soggy in the water.
It probably has been. He's been floating in the water for a while.
Oh, it's gonna be gross.
But wouldn't it make it more effective in a block then, if it's wet? Do people want to stay away from
it?
Apparently not, because Tavio rolls a 642 against Elegant, and Elegant rolls an 879. Really, it's... I would assume it's pretty uncomfortable. He's smacking Elegant in probably in the face with the soggy taco.
All that soggy flour?
Yeah, with a soggy, soggy taco.
It's kind of gross.
All that soggy flour.
Someone pull the soggy taco out.
We're just giving away Blitzball trade secrets right now. If you want a perfect block, you gotta use a soggy taco. It's the only way.
Specifically a soggy taco.
It has to be a hard taco that's been sitting in that nice salty ocean
sitting in
water.
Hanging water. Sitting in the ruby sea.
Soaking.
Absolutely soaking.
Deluging in this water. All that salt.
I'm talking wrap that up in a cloth and dunk it. Get all that water stuck in there.
If there's no seaweed on it, you messed up. You gotta start over.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, Kroa, remember during open ceremonies when the camera guy kept focusing on that one person eating bread?
Bread. Slash bread. Bread. Can we get some breads in chat?
Slash bread! Get your slash breads.
That's the only one I can find.
I don't have any emotes like that.
Yeah, I don't either.
No.
Oh,
wow.
Not rich enough to get the cool bread from Ishgard.
Ball carrier easily moves past Elegant into zone one. Now it's just up to Sammy Malkut shooting versus Kara Skyfallen. When your opening ceremony is sponsored by bread, you're gonna get a lot of bread shots. That's fair.
So, when we see an odd increase in bakery sales in correspondent Menfina Madness, we have no responsibility. That was not us.
Okay, I believe you.
It's like, man, 85 Degrees Bakery just sold out a lot of buns.
The bread stock goes up because of Menfina Madness. That was not us.
When asked for comment, only one. Everyone had to say this. Actually, they didn't say anything. It wasn't really any specific statement. They said slash bread and took a bite.
Wait, what's this?
Oh, was that a time roll? Two 463s from Naroki and Nicole. Reroll. Naroki gets 551. However, let's see. Nicole with a 584.
Blitz Nicole? Buns, yes.
Nicole keeping the center pure.
Blitz buns.
Naroki tries to slap Nicole in the face with a fluffy tail. Unfortunately, that fluffy tail is not so fluffy in the water.
Ooh.
Not to mention the amount of force required to actually whip that thing.
Combined with like the armor and the sogginess, it's can't imagine.
This is like ultimate anime episode, this like tense moment, 10 seconds left.
Indeed. And apparently the taco that Tavio used to distract was it Elegant with. He just
Elegant tries to block Tavio.
No!
Tavio with an 883. Nicole going in for a block against Naroki in response. Lancelot tries to block Tavio. Nicole manages to block Naroki in retaliation. Tavio.
Oh, but you gotta say the phrase though. You gotta say the phrase.
Ura!
There you
Ura!
Go.
Ura!
Tavio with a perfect with a nice solid defense from both blockers. Doe looks like she wants to pick a fight with East. Let's see here.
Good old rich versus poor dichotomy.
Tacos at least better have lechon.
Simon prepares to shoot.
Let's see here. Blitzball Kid with an unorthodox approach to blocking East by just throwing himself. And it seems to have worked. Distracted by Doe, East manages to get caught by Blitzball Kid's net that is his body. Sammy goes for the shot. And it's an 825 versus 638. It is a tie game now.
And apparently there are water mines thrown about this area, but they went off in the wrong spot.
Oh, well, that's... Don, come on, man. You're in foreign waters. What are you doing?
International incident, anyone? If this keeps up, we might have one. Anyway, 1-1. Guild Turtles are not looking to cash out.
Are they gonna crash out? Or are they gonna fall flat? Oh shoot, I thought of a better line, but it's too late now. And of course, the audience is getting angry. Time for the new blitz off. Tavio bringing out a burrito cannon out of nowhere now, and shooting into the crowd.
Tacos and burritos.
I am.
Oh, that's right. He does shoot those whenever a goal is made, doesn't he? He's now commanding his turtles to prepare some sort of direct deposit, whatever kind of strategy that entails.
I don't think now's the time to check your bank accounts. We're in the middle of a match here.
Seriously.
Speaking of money and checking your bank accounts, you head on over to !! Charity, all lowercase, and go ahead and donate to the Tiltify link for direct relief. Crush's turn to start. Lancelot moving straight to C. Nicole with the ball. Elegant holding her position as defense. Ooh, Doe also moving forward. Apparently, Don Coconaro is getting his technology from the goblins. Interesting folk. I wouldn't say their technology is the greatest. Obviously, it's probably going for like the Allegans or
Garland Ironworks.
Hey, but Gobby's gonna rise, boom like thunder, though.
To the L to the EX Ander.
Tavio with a burrito block against Nicole, and it seems to have worked with 927 versus 485.
It's a perfectly good burrito, though.
Oh, looks like he's actually offering it as a trade for the ball.
Oh.
And you know what? It worked. Because, man, I would. I'm very hungry.
Rolled diplomacy high enough.
Exactly. Currently less than $50 from breaking 2,000 raised for charity. It's only the second day of games. Hello? We can easily double the total from the last 4 years. Currently a 4,000, by the way. That's the total. $2,000?
Score for a cause is looking quite well.
Wow.
Ooh, score for Congrats. A cause doing that work.
Fantastic work, everybody.
Seriously. Let's see.
Everyone appears to be dumbfounded that the burrito actually worked.
Seriously though, the burrito... I would kill for a burrito right now.
It currently says the burrito always works, so...
give me like some Chipotle or...
Right? Freebirds?
La Chamoy.
This year's marks Nall's third major league season.
Put a little pico de gallo with the carne asada.
Ooh, you know what? Get some fries in there. Get that Cali burrito. Ooh, baby.
Heaven. It smells so good right now.
Baby, 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 baby. Persona 3. Nicole tries to pass it off to Doe. Unfortunately, gets the ball smacked right out of her own hand by the blockers. Naroki with the ball now. It's gonna be the Guild Turtles' turn.
Guild Turtles' ball. Let's see how long they can keep it.
So at least we know now that the Guild Turtles can market taco burrito conversations in public.
Tavio continuing the food distraction tactic. It works again! Nicole with an empty stomach on the field right now. 385 versus 327. Oof.
In their defense, she has been expending a lot of energy with those impressive blocks.
Incredible. Incredible plays, but obviously it has been doing a number on her energy. Meanwhile, now swinging at Doe with a backflip kick. Very, very athletic, very aggressive. Very successful with a 610 versus 183. Those fighter instincts kicking in for both sides.
They hit him in the center.
Now it's time for the Koban Crushers to make a move. Elegant hold the position, of course. Lancelot moving into block Naroki with a 16. Come on, man. This is 583. There's a lot of low rolls today. Lots of low rolls today. It's kind of sad. Nicole's trying to block Naroki. I believe with the block, Tavio gets to block that, right?
It
doesn't matter because he rolled low.
Yeah.
Let's see. Nicole rolls a 306, Naroki with a 394. And of course, a secondary defensive roll from against Blitzball Kid. It's a 552. And a 141. Alright, Crush's turn is up. I believe it's Ball Carrier now. All Alright, everyone getting in repositioning. I don't think anyone is actually moving, except for two people. Sammy and East moving up. Ball carrier's turn. I should attack whoever was the ball carrier. Naroki with the pass to Sammy. It's gonna be a contested roll from Naroki and Blitzball Kid. And Nicole. Oh,
tough break.
Unfortunate. Really threw them off with the bo-beep skaboop into the throw.
Where these anchors come from? Oh no!
Where did they get the anchors? Anyways, it's Don doing Don things again. Where is he? Where is that level?
I'm pretty sure there's no airships flying around right now.
Don't think so. I can't see him anywhere. It's tiny.
I'm sure I didn't hear any whistling in the wind.
It was conjured from the very ether itself.
That's some heavy ether!
I think I know someone that can deal with that ether. Auto-swimming paddles. And yes, Aetherus, we are... This whole thing is, Menfina Madness is brought to you by Score for a Cause. This whole operation is a charity event. And honestly, it's an honor to commentate for this thing.
Well said.
Now with an offense... Now with the offense kicking a dough to keep her... To keep her locked down at B. Let's see here. 951 versus 4-2. That is in fact a block. Tavio with more tacos.
Well, what? Should Kugane not become the victors, at least he can leave with a full belly.
Or at least Nicole will. Because goodness. Tavio sold the total of like, what? 4 burritos or now?
Yeah.
Like, I can barely eat one.
This is what depends on what's in
them. It all depends on what's in them, of course.
Yeah.
Those Cali burritos be big. Like my arm big.
I think they used to do that Free Bridge too. Big burrito. Roll that up.
13 minutes on the clock. Not super strong with the meat. Let's meet that goal. Hey, every cent counts. Like, what? Every donation is absolutely appreciated. And of course, we have team merch. If you want to show off your favorite team, just hit up exclamation point the team in lowercase letters. You can find the whole list in my channel description. And it just sends you right to the link to the page. Personal favorite, die cut stickers, Alamigo Royal Griffins, let's go.
Bring the thunder.
Oh, wait, no, that's the wrong, nope. It's the team names. I don't have merch.
I gotcha, let me go.
I don't have
merch. You don't have merch yet?
I'm working on it. I don't have a brand. I don't really have a brand. I just have the channel. Ball carrier's turn. It looks like elegant. Let's see what's going on. Sammy passing to Naroki. 831 versus elegant block. Probably. That's 198. I want to get like a shirt, but the page isn't working for me. I might have to switch browsers because I am on Chrome.
Good old Chrome. Eating up all that bandwidth.
Actually, it hasn't been too bad for me. I don't know.
Oh, that's pretty good. I guess on my end, it's always been like, you want data? Not anymore.
Hey, Aetherus, thank you very much for the donation. We very much appreciate your contribution. Al- Meanwhile, Sammy, with a successful pass to Naroki.
A whole team of 30 million gil worth of booby traps, and yet you're betting 50 million on the Gil Turtles winning. Okay, then. That's...
I don't know how much of a profit that is. Actually, wait a minute. East of Doe going at it. Look at that.
It's oh my goodness.
998 versus 949. That's a good fight.
The slum sapper. Oof. Ooh. Where are these devices, though?
Shoot. I gotta get rid of that auto-delete message thing. I really do gotta...
It appears Nicole's had enough tacos for now and is easily... resisted Tavio's block.
Slash mod.
Apparently there's some nice diatribe going on between the Elegant and Sammy. As she goes forth and try to block Naroki. Should he succeed, the only thing standing to him in victory will be Kara Skyfallen.
Slash DG.
She goes for a block with a 346 versus Naroki's 74.
Time's up. Sorry on my end. I was,
Oh, no big deal. Appears Doe was attempting to stab East with a knife, but East dodges.
DG Hibbity, just gotta make sure I got the capitalization right. There you go. That should be everyone that I need to mod. I'll check the actual... Ooh, we're sitting at $2,009.28 for charity. Amazing. Let's go, everybody.
All right.
Only third week of Manfino Madness. Still got a long ways to go. We aren't even halfway. We're breaking records, bro.
Very nice.
Got a good feeling.
Couple.
And if you happen to be subscribed to my channel, actually no. If you have better TTV, if you type it. BOGGERS in all caps. It's basically my own POG.
Oh, nice.
Naroki attempts to pass back over to Sammy, but Elegant easily prevents that with a 776. Almost lucky sevens.
Elegant with the ball. Mini toss sent me a private message. You check our menu, you won't crave a burrito anymore. Turtle menu. Eat like a turtle, a gill turtle. Let's go.
Ball is now in Kugani's possession. Meanwhile, it appears that Doe is attempting to move back to the zone 2 once more.
Meanwhile, this person is just out here trying to fish. The hustle is real.
Well, she can't fish inside of a... she can't listen or blitz. She can't fish inside of a sphere, so...
Well, she's just off to the side. It's fine.
Earlier they were shooting off fireworks.
Hey! You love to see it. I seem to be... message or something? What was that? I got a notification for a thing, but I don't see where it is. Oh. Probably nothing. Alright.
East with some foresight is attempting to reinforce Lane over at the goalpost.
And it looks like Elegant is free from any blockers, and now it's her turn to make a move.
A 2v2 situation back in the Gill Turtles' goalpost. Not again, he says. Such is the life of a goalkeeper.
Stick and move. Oh, that's what it is.
Nicole attempts to block East to help give Doe some cover. With a full-on wrestling hold.
Absolutely, and that's going to be a 608 versus 267 in Nicole's favor.
Looks like those tackles were well needed. She's got her energy back. Absolutely. Was looking to choke out East.
Looks like Tavio's efforts to distract Nicole are going a little sideways for the rest of his team. Accidentally aiding the enemy.
Looks like Kid attempts to go for a sneak attack, but is rolling a 28 versus East's 551.
Oof, the Blitzball Kid is really just not having a good day. He had that 958 earlier, and that was just downhill. Back downhill.
It was Eat. A nice tactic, yes.
Oh, victory music is already playing. Are we? It's not over yet, right? No,
that's how the lineup is.
Yeah. Psytube is just... Psytube. We currently only have 4 minutes on the clock, though, so someone's got to make a move, otherwise he's going to go to a shoot-off. From the rookie, Sammy with a 979. Ooh, Elegant with the great defense. Look at that, 733 and 988.
Yeah, that momentary pause to eat was definitely deserved.
Incredible. Ball carrier's position, Elegant is free to move. Alright, she could move into C to give her some breathing room, but she will be contending with Tavia McGill later. Or she could just go straight for it and pass on the Doe. Or even Nicole for that matter. Oh wait. Oh, she already
passed the
Doe. Doe is the ball carrier. I forgot to update. And that's actually Doe with a goal with a 312 versus Lane's 205. Let's get some Washoys in the chat. Doe with the second score of the game and is now 2-1 back in Kugane's favor. Koban Crusher is crushing more than Koban.
They're crushing Gil too.
Crushing Copa, crushing Gil, crushing Dreams. Let's It's just a, it's a master. Your Jimbo's having a good day.
So is this representation that the Koban is better value than the Gil? Is this like a market statement?
I'm not entirely sure of the conversion rate, to tell you the truth.
I'm also not actually sure.
Like, I think it's mark equivalent, but from this match results, I don't know. It's starting to look like Koban's gonna have more value. Yo, Jimbo's making some gil.
The final blitz off. It's gonna be set. Nicole with the final ball. You can easily hold it off, wait for the. Make the last play. They could just make a shot, really. It all depends on these next two turns.
Would they be so daring?
Can we have the extra tacos after the match? That's what I want.
Oh, I'm sure they are. It doesn't seem like that cannon atop you isn't running short on ammo anytime soon.
Also, with the bold taco no takoyaki, yes. Actually, I don't remember the last time I had takoyaki. I should look into those again.
I actually had it yesterday. It was quite good.
As did I.
Ah, y'all lucky.
Well, I live in Japan, so...
Fair enough.
And a new shop just opened up down the street, so it was like, huh, I'll try it for lunch. And boom,
winning.
Takoyaki.
I can't remember if there's a takoyaki... If there's a place near me that sells takoyaki.
I just happened to get lucky that my coworker was just like, hey, we should use some ramen. A new place opened up. It was like, okay. And I found it.
Nice.
Someone in the crowd is yelling for knife, 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 knife. Blood, blood, blood.
Is that a signature move of those or something?
That is someone from the crowd, I think. Yep.
Yep.
Someone, well, you know what? The audience calls for blood. We do give them blood. Nosebleeds, maybe a stab wound.
Now, blood in the water will attract sharks. Actual sharks.
I mean, I'm pretty sure we have some security on in the teams and in the audience.
Yes, and in case the Seki Sagumi are listening, we didn't encourage any of this.
I believe you.
I'm sure we're fine. Let's see the defense on Nicole over here. Does it seem like there's anything? No, they're all actually holding. Are they looking to see if she... No, they're not planning something, are they? They all held. Guild Turtles have something up their sleeve. Dawn's probably got something planned. Something's not right. Why'd the music stop?
The Guild Turtles are playing Diamond Hands here.
They're playing the Jaws theme.
Oh, goodness.
Who brought the... Who gave the Guild Turtles a speaker?
I wonder.
There it is. Welcome to Blitzball, where pretty much everything, or at least most things, are legal. Including a whole shark.
including using very old food as a distraction weapon.
It's effective.
Super effective.
That's a 508. It's not going to meet them. Lane Krieger, unfortunately, gets a plus 400 from the distance. So it's going to be a block. I just realized I misspelled here. College student, by the way.
Words are hard. Don't worry.
English is a mess.
It is a mess. I hate it.
Lane catches and goes for a goal-to-goal shot? Careful with the 474, but with that distance, I believe that's 2, 3, 4, 2, 4, 6, 8, plus 800?
Oh my.
Oh dear.
It was a good attempt, but it just wasn't it. Ah, and it seems that Don's got some Magitek sharks.
Oh.
Now we know where the music was coming from. Apparently he installed speakers in the shark's gills.
Phenomenal.
And that's going to be the game. Kugane Koban Crushers taking the win for today's first game. 2-1. Despite all of Don Coconero's blatant attempts to sabotage the game, he is now down 80 million gil.
Yes, 30 million from the nonsense and 50 million for the bets. What a bad day to represent Ulda today.
And if if Don Coconero and my time in Grand Blue Fantasy's casino has taught me anything, gambling is not good.
Never is.
Gambling is quite painful. East. East once again threatening the lives of orphans. Let's give like some golf claps for Blitzball Kid. Very, very, very low rolls. He had the one. It was just the kid. You'll get there.
He had that one break, but he did just clear in victory.
Eat some blitz bread, and then we're good to go.
He helped the team secure victory. I think he's well on the path.
Yep. You know what? He used his body to keep the others distracted. Used up their turns. It's a very valid strategy.
For sure.
Yeah. And now, a quick message from our sponsors. This is gonna be fun. I've always wanted to use one of these.
It's Blitz season once again! The City Friends of Idleshire proudly present Far Shock Shortstop Dunker Splody Boo! Come on down for all your favorite fireworks and explosives! We've got Fizzle Pucks, Sparkle Sticks, Whistle Shots, Melon Boots, Apple Boots, Stick Boots, TikTok, and Signal Boots! And do not miss out on the limited edition Mammoth Babu! Mention this ad and get 10% off of your order at checkout. First 100 customers get a free rocket tube and sunglasses, because cool friends don't look at explosions. Don't miss out on your chance to take out your enemies with enough explosive to level Balzar's wall! Far Shark's short stops of Kersplody Booms, your one-stop shop for all things kaboom!
That was Far Shocks' shortstop of Kersplody Booms, sponsor of Kugane Koban Crushers, today's first victor of the game. Don't forget, if you want explosives, or fireworks, or a combination of both, there you go. In fact, we got another, I think we got another sponsor lined up somewhere. Let me see if I can get a good one. You know what? Honorable mention to the Guild Turtles. I'm assuming that this is one of their sponsors. Just double checking. Guild Tribe. Yep, that's old dog. Time for the Guild Tribe.
Hey, you smug. Yeah, you with the face. That's right, I'm talking to you. Do you run an independent business? Do you own a chocobo carriage or some fancy, some elegant two-wheeler? Do you have skin that can bruise and bleed? Then you need the best protection Guild can buy. Guild Tribe Protection. For only 49,099 gills a week, you can be graced with the most Guild wishes protection of not having your face beaten or your stuff messed up by low-level thugs like myself and my brother.
That's right. The world's a scary place. Why not have...
I'm so sorry, I forgot that the ad was playing on Discord and I clicked a different channel.
Has skin that can beat in, or your stuff messed there. Up by low-level thugs
there
like
you go.
Myself and my brother.
That's right, the world's a scary place. Why not have one less thing to worry about, you mook? Guild Tribe Protection offers 3 levels of security. Yous can sign up for our basic boy package, our Guild package, or our Mikolte Shore package.
With each package, you get a sticker. You can put the sticker on your business window, or your chocobo. What am I, freaking home decorator? I don't care where you put it. The sticker shows everyone,
especially the Guild Tribe,
that you are under the protection of the Guild Tribe. Ain't nobody gonna mess with you when you purchase Guild Tribe Protection.
Especially us!
And that was the Guild Tribe, sponsor of Old Dog Guild Turtles. Today's first sponsor.
I may actually go into debt to get some protection.
I think I got myself handled, thank you.
Right, it's a good option. I mean, it's there, you know. They seem pretty confident in their skills of protection.
Well, with an accent like that. Yeah, with an accent like that, I would trust it.
They got stickers too.
So I'm so excited. The stickers.
always love a good sticker. Them die cut stickers and the merch. Good stuff. You put on a bottle, you put on your computer, put on your laptop, put on yourself, I don't care.
Put it's it not on your water flask.
You put on yourself, but, you know. And of course, today's next match is going to be let me go.
Evilies.
The
Evilies High Seraphs.
Evilies High Seraphs and the Garlemald Salt Barons.
Make sure to keep your Arasite out of the audience.
Yep, gotta make sure you keep your crystals somewhere safe. You never know what might happen. You never know what kind of tactics anyone might be up to. Don.
Don. Just Don.
Coconero. Yeah? I got my eye on you.
If we see Lukavi anywhere, we know something's up.
Oh my.
Just a quick break might. Look at some stuff. Check on some stuff. So I got messages and stuff. Oh, I don't. Stretch my legs a bit. I always gotta remember to keep your legs limber because, my goodness.
Well, now, that was quite the explosive ad.
Kaboom?
How do I hear myself? Oh, they're playing it on SciTube, okay. I was like, why am I hearing the ads again? I thought I left that channel. That's not working. We're currently just in the middle of a nice break. Probably want to get some water, everybody. Make sure you stay hydrated.
Please. Always remember to hydrate.
Absolutely. Get yourself like a 24-ounce bottle and you're pretty much covered. None of that 8 glasses a day stuff. Just get yourself a bottle of water. Like something refillable so you don't waste anything. And just drink when you're thirsty. That's it. That's the science.
What, you mean coffee's not water?
No!
I wouldn't... No.
Again, for emphasis, no!
But bean juice makes me go voom voom!
But, yes, it may. It may. However, come a pause, it will dehydrate you. So if you're going to drink coffee, make sure you're hydrated beforehand. You'll get more energy that way. Logic.
And no Monster. No Monster energy drinks. I don't count. Oh,
that was my net.
Drink 8 of those.
Oh no!
That's not good for your heart.
They're just real.
Tilp's going to the moon in real life.
Let us know what it is.
Yeah, liquor's a liquid. That makes
liquor's a liquid, but it ain't healthy.
Yes, but liquor's also a depressant.
It's an antidepressant.
And a diuretic. That's the proper term for it, right? Diuretic, it makes you want to go to the bathroom.
Yes.
There you go.
Or laxative.
Oh!
Okay, that's a different... That's a different
matter
entirely.
Yeah, that's for consumption.
No, but seriously, drink water.
On that note, I'm gonna go get some water.
Actually, yeah, I gotta drink something too.
I'll be right back.
Shoot, I already got 3 bottles ready to go.
Let's see if the Be Right Back screen is updated. Yes, it is. Oh, no, it's not. Hold on. I gotta adjust all these.
Wait.
I was gonna say, why is that one so small compared to the other one?
There you go.
Looks like somebody's taking the stage right now.
evil these high serifs take to the sphere? Being the wild card team for 2-3 years running?
Well, it seems like it. Sorry, just came back with...
No worries, the evil these high serifs just took to the sphere.
Yep. Oh, that's not it, that's not it either. There you go.
Cosplaying the Zodiac Braves. Amazing.
Oh, it's impeccable. I love it.
Incredible attention to detail.
They even have Curiosity Blanchemont cosplaying as Evil or Ultima the High Seraph herself. We have Poides as Pure as Mustadio Bonanza. Aurora Delacroix as Meliadul Tengil.
So, it seems that someone is yelling, one is not a prime number. For everybody that is caught up on Stormblade content, it's not a prime number. It's not a prime number. No matter what you think, no matter what your logic is, it's not a prime number. Oh, add a plus one. Add a one. Please. Save yourself.
To say shout out to Yasui Matsuno for reviving an old mathematics debate in current era.
Should we refer to them by their actual names or by their actual character?
I would say by their names for convenience for the audience.
Agreed.
And for people that may or may not be familiar with the, the performing troupe.
Or even Final Fantasy Tactics, for that matter. Wait, what's this? Not the Imperial March.
Of course it's the Imperial March. What do you expect? It's the metal version, too. Here's hoping the streams don't get demonetized for any of this.
Oh, they will.
Absolutely.
I hate to be that bearer of bad news.
Yeah. I mean, that's
it's the cover. We should be fine.
I mean, it's the cover, but then we also had the Jaws theme. We had,
Oh, damn it.
Right. What was that song that played in the beginning?
Unfortunate.
When we covered the opening... Yeah, when we were covering the opening ceremonies, the whole thing got taken down because of all the... music that was
good songs.
Good songs. Not friendly for us.
Not stream friendly for sure.
I mean, they are stream friendly, just not video on demand.
Here they come.
Make way for the Garla Malt Salt Man.
A fantastic bold move for them to come back again after last year's events. For everyone that is not familiar, Salt Barons actually got to a little bit of a kerfuffle at the site of their last loss, their second loss in the competition, facing 0-2 overall in terms of win-loss ratios. They were set for execution, apparently, by the Empire. And of course, us fellow players and fans of Blitzball, that's gonna be a no-go. Someone set off an EMP. We, not only do we not know who it was, but we will also not name names. We'll be dead in the ground before we out anyone. We started a very different kind of riot. sing. Music's cut off.
Cue the better music. Lift off!
Oh, it's begins. A blitz off, and Leo starting off not so strong with a 21. Trinity actually getting the ball for the Garlemald Assault Barons. It's gonna be a game.
Yes, it is. Garlemald Ball!
Once again, it's going to be 60 minutes on that clock, always counting down, despite no matter what turn it is.
And the donor's asking if his aim is off.
Salt Barons still yet to make their turns. Talon Kane staying put. Felix Bastion moving towards B. Nave actually looking to block off Aurora. Oh.
Nave, no!
Nave, please! Aurora, come on, let up! I already rolled an 83. High Seraph Curie out the gate with an Aether Tackle. Unfortunately, Trinity saw it coming from a mile away. That's going to be a 164 versus 610, an unsuccessful offense. Leo this time taking their turn. Oh, a fairer fight. Unfortunately, 604 versus 849 is not going to cut it. Meanwhile, Aurora is looking to push towards A, free for movement. Goes that blitz music. Ball carrier's turn. Trinity moving on up. Don Coconero effect. They say Trinity can catch a blitz ball going 450 miles per hour underwater.
That's awfully fast indeed. Wow.
That's fast and quite possibly
deadly.
Lethal.
Yes.
Question. How would you get a ball to go that fast underneath water with all the water resistance?
Just have Seriously. A really good arm.
Either.
Either a really good arm or a very powerful cannon that provides or hydrodynamic ability.
Gotcha.
Chat says try.
This ball is hydrodynamically designed.
Felix Aqua dynamic.
Like Kamome with a hug.
Wait, what?
Felix is going to block Kamome with a hug. A 924 beats a 794.
Let's see.
Seems to be a lot of hugs in
Asa going for a hug against Aurora. 615 versus 611. It's not the tightest grip, but it's still something to get her down. High Seraph's turn. Rostolphus Orlando going in. Roscoe rolls a 634. Trinity gets blocked with a roll of 160.
Aurora's looking to counter block Asuna with her own hug.
It is.
I didn't know this was an intimate moment between the teams.
Let's see, Asuna rolling a 257. It is in fact a mutual hugging.
Well, you two enjoy that. We'll get back to the action.
Let's see here, Kamome. Kamome fighting Felix. It is a 642 versus 612. 742 versus 612. Sorry.
Oh, Poidessa is with a stinging remark regarding Garlemald's secession from All Amigo. Should still be Garlemald's ball.
Still Garlemald's ball. Trinity is bogged down by one blocker from Roscoe Rackham. Let's see what she planned.
Everyone is advanced forward, leaving the center wide open.
This is an unfamiliar sight. Trinity's going for the shot. Two blockers and plus 200 from the goalie. Goes right past Roscoe.
Roscoe misses.
Oh, and Poidessus with the 707 and a 200 for the distance. That's gonna be a big old block by the goalie. And now the ball's in Poidessus' hands. He can pass it off to Curie or Leo, or even Aurora.
High Seraph ball.
High Seraph flying through.
A bold gambit from Trinity. The Poidessus was ready to intercept.
And now it's Poidessus with the choice of passing it off to one of the three offensive lines. Oh, and he makes the pass to Curie. Alright. Now it's the actress for the High Seraph herself. Unforgiven Curiosity. With the ball.
Curie for short, grabs it with a sphere grid of scary looking magic. Oof. That's not for boarding at all.
Definitely not. Oh,
Aurora blocks Asuna using her ears with a 770 versus a 341. I suppose that's one way of being resourceful as a Viera.
Hey, this is quite unfortunate, but I have to log off to go eat dinner. Unfortunately, this will have to be my time. You can still catch the action on twitch.tv/CGHiguri or twitch.tv/the_Esalen. This was Gale Lightrun / Curious Instigator, streaming whenever he can.
A pleasure having you as always.
I need to fix the stream ending logos. I have a well. This has been once again been an honor, and I will see everyone another time.
Till next time.
Bye. I love you all. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy. And support the Royal Griffins. Bye.